2 days ago, one of my favorite writers mentioned Oshun, the African goddess of love and sweet waters. She lives in the rivers, he said. Her sister, Yemaya, lives in the painting of my mermaid. I speak to her with my eyes and see her with my womb. In reality, she is the ocean, the mother, and the warrior. Oshun is a seductress of sorts, soaked in amber, draped in gold and coral, my sex. People cannot resist her. There's a space in between these two sisters where ladies live. It is called fear. Fear, too much sex, too much love, too much mothering, too much water, too much, too much, too much. So they dull their woman parts and put them into pictures, perfumes, and colors. Drape themselves in the incantation of the insides. Live between the river and the ocean, somewhere on land where you can't feel the flow. I want to be a woman, not a lady. I wonder what I could do if the flow was in me, if the people around me said yes to my dreams, if I stopped living every day as if sameness was normal. It's hard to go it alone, though. A musician said that once, and I listened. If there are two, one can live insane, while the other grows her mane, and then they can switch, ending each day with more hair and more power. But when you tell them it can work this way, they tell you you're a temptress, living in a field of flowers, forgetting about the cement. When you tell them you woke up knowing it was possible, they laugh and tell you a story to bring you back to their reality. They take Oshun and Yemi out with them. They take the woman and make you a lady. So I sit staring at my pictures, talking to the animals, the goddesses, and the mermaids, filling the empty oils with my flow, knowing there will be enough women for us all when we decide to break free. But until then, I'll write a poem. It goes like this. I put her in my worldview, and when she became a citizen, I realized I didn't want to be one anymore. I looked to my left, to my right, and it came to me. There are no citizens, only patrons. That's when I left. Buy attention, buy likes, buy perception, and leave the authenticity in the air, breathing a nugget too far from the ground. Sentient beings? No. There's nothing sentient about faux fur on whale sperm and your anti-wrinkle cream. Nothing sentient about half-smoked cigarettes wrapped in lipstick like prosciutto tucked around a melon. Leave out the sweet and savory and all you see is the cured leg and pesticides. Nothing sentient about a home without a willow, standing on one leg hoping you'll grow leaves. Nothing sentient about $65 cover-up, the kind that's safe from toxins, you know? Let the poor people die. Nothing sentient about telling her you'll have her in her office while the teenagers she teaches about societal constructs sit outside. Nothing sentient about blaming an animal activist for not caring enough about the people who are dying. Everyone needs to act somewhere. It's all fucked. Nothing sentient about not working because you don't fit into the system or working because you've been trained to. They're both disturbing. Nothing sentient about being pushed out or being pushed in. Gentrification is unleashed while our dogs are tied tight. You can move into a neighborhood and get the people who've been there all their lives kicked out because their music's too loud and their skin is too scary or their people make you uncomfortable when they sit on the stoop, but you can't walk a dog in a park without a leash. You can smoke a cigarette and throw it to the curb, but you gotta pick up the shit. So you stand over your little cocker poodle or whatever inhumane mix they made to woo you, and you watch her squat, bending down to remove the waste when she's done. Leashes for holding, plastic bags for cleaning, cigarettes for smoking, makeup for hiding, trees for cutting, pig legs for eating, pesticides for killing, price tags for raising. Oh yeah, don't forget the alcohol for escaping. Go to work another day so you can pay for it. Money for paying, holding, cleaning, cutting, eating, killing, raising, escaping. Go to bed so you can do it again. And if you can't sleep because the music next door is too loud, call the landlords so they can heighten the price and make it quiet, silence your fear into dreamless slumber. Nothing sentient about being fearful. So close your eyes, love, and it'll all go away. When I'm done, I look over at the mermaids, the goddesses, the peacocks, the oceans, the rivers, the animals, and I tell them, I want to be fearless, not fearful. I want to be alive with sex. I want to be a mother to more than a child. I want to be a warrior for myself and others. I want to be hair from head to toe, draped in power. I want to be fields of flowers, not cement. I want to be rivers, ocean, lakes, and quarries. I want to be a woman, not a lady. And then I go to sleep hoping my pictures will follow me there.